Law and Order on Vax Serb Unit.
While it hits the courts tomorrow, documents submitted by Novak's lawyers late yesterday reveal Djokovic claims he tested positive to COVID-19 on the 16th of December, which is a bummer for everyone who came into contact with him afterwards because Novak did not isolate. Here he is in the days after his diagnosis, maskless and attending ceremonies, meeting kids and giving interviews. Now, the COVID diagnosis date is important because Novak believed it would secure him entry to Australia, i.e. he could enter despite not getting a vaccine because he'd had the virus within the past 6 months. He probably thought that because of this leaked Tennis Australia letter telling him this was indeed a valid reason for a medical exemption.
And you can get the green tick.
Compounding his confidence, on January 1st, Novak, already holding a temporary activity visa, also received a document from the Department of Home Affairs, which he reckoned granted him a quarantine-free arrival. Problem is, that document was merely an indicative indication of his eligibility based on his own declaration, not a binding exemption. Also, Tennis Australia's advice was incorrect and their medical exemption meaningless at customs. So now he's holed up in the Park Hotel with a cancelled visa.
Hey, Djokovic, play!
Oh, mate, I haven't slept since he's come off the plane.
Novak's lawyers claim he was shocked, surprised and confused and are fighting to let him stay. Today, it's been revealed Home Affairs Minister Karen Andrews last night applied for a 48-hour adjournment to help build their case. The judge rejected that request.
It's embarrassing and the world is watching.
Despite the fallout, Tennis Australia's CEO Craig Tiley has praised his organisation in an internal video.
A lot of finger-pointing going on and a lot of blaming going on, but I can assure you our team has done an unbelievable job and have done everything they possibly could according to all the instructions that they have been provided.
But mystery also swirls around another Tennis Australia letter from the 7th of December that stressed players need to apply for a medical exemption to a vaccine by December 10. If Novak got COVID on December 16, it wouldn't have been in his paperwork. I know, Susie, we're all confused as hell.
Thank you to people around the world for your continuous support. I can feel it, and it is greatly appreciated.
If he's allowed to play the Australian Open, I don't want any bar of him. I reckon he's going to be pissed off.
Like every parent, you would never expect this to happen to your child, and I feel sick now, I could cry, so I can't comment anymore, but it's devastating.
Law and Order on Vax Serb Unit.
Well, Justin Quill is a partner at major law firm Thompson Gear Lawyers and joins us now. So, Justin, will Djokovic get to play in the Oz Open?
Well, I reckon he will win his case tomorrow in the Federal Circuit Court. That doesn't necessarily mean he'll play in the Oz Open. I think what is most likely is that the judge will decide that the deportation order was invalid or invalidly made and will then remit it back to the Minister for Home Affairs to make a decision or remake a decision. And what that will be, who knows? If I was a betting man, well, actually, who am I kidding? I am a betting man. My money is on that he will play.
So, Justin, what were the sort of arguments that have convinced you that he'll probably get to play that his legal team filed yesterday?
Look, it mainly went to the process in which the orders, the deportation order was made, not given enough time to respond to what the Border Force people were saying. He had no sleep, he was 25 hours in transit, he wasn't given access, so he says at least, wasn't given access to a lawyer. And then the actual decision, what they relied on and took into account and didn't take into account are also the grounds that Djokovic is arguing makes this deportation order invalid.
Do you think the fact that his exemption was approved by two panels conducting blind assessments will hold any weight?
Look, that's probably really relevant in the court of public opinion, but I don't think it's going to make much of a difference tomorrow. The judge is not going to be too concerned about what a doctor did or didn't say a month or so ago. He's going to be interested in and concerned about the process that was undertaken last Thursday at the airport.
The government sought an 11th hour adjournment. What does that mean? If we were reading between the lines, are they packing their dacks?
They did. I mean, this was a very interesting revelation. That tells me two things. One, they realise there's more in this than they first thought and they've got a real fight on their hands. And two, they're scrambling and they're on the back foot.
Justin, late this afternoon, more letters were revealed between Tennis Australia and the state and federal governments, which make it look like there was a lot of confusion over exactly who could grant the exemption. Do you think that that bodes well for Novak?
I'm not sure they'll be overly relevant, although if the matter is remitted back to the ministers, I think is very likely. This is going to become a political hot potato, and those letters, who knew what, when, that's going to be very relevant. And we've all seen a lot of finger pointing now. I think if this judge does as I expect and remits it to the minister, there'll be a hell of a lot more finger pointing at that stage. And this is really going to become a massive political issue.
Whether you're a tennis fan or not, I think this has captured most people's attention, and something that a lot of people are wondering about is that if this drags on much longer, how much is it going to cost the Australian taxpayer?
Stacks. Look, if there is no appeal, then it's probably going to be maybe $250,000. If there are appeals, it could be more like $500,000. Novak Djokovic, if he wins his case, he'll seek his costs, and we'll have to whack that on top of $250,000. So, look, if he wins tomorrow, $250,000 to the government lawyers, then probably $200,000 to Novak to pay his legal fees. We're getting pretty close to $500,000, and that's just if there's no appeal.
Justin Quill, great chatting to you tonight. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.